CTW presents Sesame Street Show 2058.
Oscar, what's going on?
Yeah.
Hey, quiet. I'm listening to their music here. If you can't get with it, get lost.
What music?
You can't hear this, Mr. Music? Hey, hold it, Slimy. Take five. We got a couple of squares here. You know, it just so happens that Slimy here and his friends have formed a rock group. They play their own kind of music. Damp rock.
Well, what's the group's name?
Earth, Rain, and Mud.
Oh,
Earth.
Yeah, Slimy got tired of playing and singing alone, so we got together and cooperated, and have they got a sound. Look at the little microphones I made in there, see?
Nice.
Yeah,
great.
They've got a great sound. Here, I'll turn up the volume. You'll hear them this time. Okay, hit it, gang. Now dig this.
Excellent. Oh, what can I say?
Radical.
Think you can circle me? Oh, hey, pretty good. Okay, now try this. Draw a line to me. Not bad. Say, can you follow me around with arrows? Not bad. I can't fool you. Pretty good, pretty good. Okay, you did that well. But can you cross me out? Hey, that's fast. Wow. Okay, enough, enough. Are you ready for a toughie? Try underlining me. Very, very good. Okay, we're all done. You can take your line back now. Whoa! Hey, what happened?
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Music.
Music? What? Me try. Me.
No.
What do you want, Jack?
I did more.
Okay.
One second. Hey. Yeah. Did the Monday Mama say?
Nobody.
No music. Music, yeah, music.
Yeah, music.
Good night, baby.
Get it moving. Get it moving along the ground. That's it. All right. Up the hill. Up the hill. Up toward the top. Let's get it up to the peak. A little bit more. A little bit more. All right. Hold it. Hold it. That's it. All right. All right. Everybody now. All together.
Cue.
Here we go. Hold it. Look out. Look out. All right. You got to get there. You got to walk. Up.
I'm in love with you, pretty baby. I'm in love with you, yes siree. Your face, your eyes, your smile beyond compare. They fly me through the air to paradise. I'm in love with you, pretty baby. I'm in love with you, can't you see? And if someday my dreams can all come true, there'll be another pretty baby like you. Your face, your eyes, your smile beyond compare. They fly me through to paradise. I'm in love with you, pretty baby. I'm in love with you, can't you see? And if someday my dreams can all come true, there'll be another pretty baby like you.
This is the letter Q.
How'd you do that?
Do what?
How did you hang that funny-looking thing in the air like that?
That's not a funny-looking thing.
It looks like a funny-looking thing.
Well, that's because you don't know what the letter Q looks like.
I don't know what the letter Q looks like? That's a laugh.
No, this is a laugh. And I still say, you don't know what the letter Q looks like.
I do so. It looks like a, well, it's sort of a, it's kind of, I mean, it's kind of a...
Would you like a hint?
Yeah.
Well, it looks exactly like this.
Oh, you mean this funny-looking thing hanging here?
Yes, this is the letter Q.
Now you're telling me this is the letter Q.
Yes, 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 it's the letter Q, Q, Q.
Oh.
It's used all the time. It begins such words as quick, quiet, quarrel, quit. It's the letter Q. Do you hear?
Perfectly.
Now, are there any questions?
Yes. How'd you do that?
Do what?
Hang that funny-looking thing in the air like that.
That's not a funny-looking thing.
You're a funny-looking thing.
And now, Sesame Street proudly presents Caveman Days! The show that lets you see how things were way back when. Today's episode, Taking the Kid to School. Yes, even way back when in Caveman Days, each morning, the typical caveman father would take his typical caveman baby son to nursery school. Yes, each morning the caveman father would say to his caveman baby son,
Mocha, mocha, mocha!
Which meant,
okay, my caveman baby son, it's time for us to take a walk and drop you off at school.
To which the baby son would reply,
Mocha, mocha, mocha!
Which meant,
right on, Dad.
And so the caveman father and his baby son would walk to the corner of the caveman street, where the baby son would then say,
Mega, Mega, Mega!
Which meant,
Is it okay to cross the street now, Dad?
And the father would reply,
Biggie, Biggie, Muggle!
Which meant?
Well, look at that sign over there, my caveman baby son. See, that sign says, don't walk. So we'd better not try to cross the street right now.
And then the baby son would say,
Ugga wagga wagga magga hugga.
Which meant?
Why not?
And the caveman father would reply,
Boogie Mogul Mogul!
Which meant?
Well, there are many reasons, my caveman son. One of them, you see, there might be a very large dinosaur coming walking down the street towards us, and we don't want to get in his way. And matter of fact, look out! Ooh, that was a big one. That's just one reason that when that sign says, don't walk, we must be sure not to walk. And you know, the sign also says, don't walk, because somebody might be driving to work and we wouldn't want to cross the street against traffic.
And at this moment, each morning, the caveman baby son would look at his father and say,
Migga, 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 migga!
Which meant?
But, Dad, we're cavemen. Cars haven't been invented yet. Cars won't be invented for millions of years.
To which the caveman father would reply,
Hooga booga boo!
Which meant?
Never mind.
And at just that moment, the don't walk sign would change. And instead of don't walk, the sign would now say, walk. Oh. And the caveman father would hold his baby's hand and cross on their way to work and school. Be sure to tune in next time for another episode of Caveman Day.
Oh, boy. What a nice sign. D O N T W A L K D O N T W A O K WALK 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 Don't. Don't walk. Oops. Don't walk. Gee, and I was in a hurry, too.
We take you now to our monster on the spot with a fast-breaking news story.
Oh, am I on?
I think so, yes.
Oh, thank you. This is Telly Monster on the street here, where someone is about to make some exciting news. He's gonna try to make friends with a bunch of people he's never met before. Are you really gonna try this?
Yeah, I am. Yes, yes.
Wow, that's really brave.
Well, not really. I've done this kind of thing before.
No kidding? Well, how are you going to do it this time, huh?
Well, I'll probably say hello to one person and tell them my name.
Yeah, and then what?
And then maybe they'll tell me their name. And if I'm lucky enough, they'll ask me to meet the rest of their friends.
Oh, easy as that, huh?
Well, I hope so.
Okay. Are you ready?
Well, almost. Now, but first I want to do a little warm-up, okay?
Okay. Ooh.
Yo-hoo.
Okay. Okay, y'all set?
Okay.
Here we go, folks. Let's watch a man making friends.
Hello, I'm Billy D. Williams. What's your name?
Me? My name's Telly.
Well, I'm new on Sesame Street. I don't know anybody.
Really? Well, gosh, would you like to meet some of my friends, huh?
That would be great.
Okay. Hey, everybody. Everybody, come over here. Come over here. I want you all to meet a new friend of mine, Mr. Billy D. Williams.
Hi,
Wow.
Hi, I'm Maria.
Hi, Maria. Hello.
Hi, my name is
I'm Bob. Nice to see you.
Hi, I'm Olivia.
Hi, Olivia.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Gordon.
Hi, Gordon.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Yeah, I'm thinking about moving in this neighborhood here.
Really?
Really?
I've always got all sorts of friends now. Okay, this is Telly, your monster on the spot, reporting for Sesame Street News.
L. Light.
Huh? Oh my God.
L.
Lefty, come here.
Yeah, boss?
Come here. All right. Now listen good and listen tight, because I'm going to give you this one time, and I don't want to have to tell you again. You understand?
Right.
Okay, now here it is. A, B, C, D. E, F, G, H. I, J, K, L. M N O P Q R S T U V W X Y Z. You got it?
Right, boss.
Okay, give it back to me.
Give it back to you?
That's what I said.
Right, boss, right. Let's see, there was A.
Yeah.
B, C, D, E, F, G.
Yeah, go on.
G, H, I, J, K, L, M.
M what?
N.
And don't you forget it.
Right. Then comes O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V.
Yeah.
And, let's see, there's, W, X, and, there's Y and Z. Z, yeah, that's it, boss.
Yeah, hey, you did real good. I got a lollipop for you.
Oh, boy, for me, that's great. I love lollipops.
Yeah, you really knew your alphabet good.
I try hard. Is that a raspberry or pineapple?
Oh, this is even better than that.
What's that?
Q. Quiet.
Let's go get some honey. Bees make honey from nectar. Nectar is the juice they collect from flowers.
I see a bee there. I see two bees there. It's full of bees. And there's one.
You have to be careful around bees. Sometimes they sting. Beekeepers wear protective clothing. Honeybees live together in a hive. Smoke from the beekeeper's smoke pot keeps the bees quiet. Then the beekeeper can take out the honeycombs. You can eat honey right from the honeycomb. Or you can squeeze it from the comb with the honey press.
Roses are red. Oh. Ah. Violets are blue. Sugar is sweet. Oh, and so are you. Oh.
Okay, Grouchketeers. We have a new Grouchketeer coming today. And as soon as he gets here, we're going to play Grouch football. Kick the can.
Yeah!
Oh, where is he?
Dear, my first Grouchketeer meeting and I'm late. Oh, they'll probably make me stand in the corner. They probably won't let me play any of the games.
Hey, big fella, how'd you get here? By ox cart?
Oh, I'm sorry I'm late, Oscar. Can I still play?
Yeah, well, maybe if you stop saying you're sorry. Grouchketeers are never sorry. And they like being late. You got a lot to learn there, Shaggy Face. What did keep you?
Well, I had trouble getting the lid off my trash can to put on my head.
Whoa, that trash can lid is tremendous. Kids' trash can lids are small because their trash cans are small. Wait a minute. If his trash can lid is that big, then his trash can must be huge, too. And if the trash can is huge, then it must be full of tremendous, humongous trash. Yeah.
Well, Oscar, can I still play?
Can you play? You big palooka, I got bigger plans than that for you. Since you're our newest Grouchketeer, why don't you go home and bring us all your trash, and you can be the star of Trash and Tell.
Oh, boy. My first day as a Grouchketeer, and I can be the star of Trash and Tell? Oh, I'll go get it right away.
Okay, but just hurry up, hurry!
Oh, boy. I'm hurrying.
Okay. Man, I can't wait to see what he brings.
Let's kick the can!
Oh, yeah, okay, here we go with a kick the can game. Okay, go for it, go for it. Oh, boy. I'm gonna get some Snuffleupagus trash. This could be the start of something big.
Beautifulness. To me, it certainly
today. It makes you all wet.
Merciful puzzlement. What do you mean, Timmy?
I mean, I'm getting all wet, Mommy. Aren't you getting all wet?
Why, no.
That's strange. Oh, dear. I am getting all wet.
Are you getting all wet?
Oh, yes. So am I.
I'm not.
That's strange.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Am I getting wet?
Are you getting wet?
He's getting wet.
We're all getting wet.
I'm not.
That's strange.
Say, Mommy, how come we're getting wet and you're not?
Land sakes to confusionosity. I have no idea.
Say, maybe this is the kind of beautiful day when little kids get all wet and grown-ups stay dry. I didn't know there were days like that.
Oh, that can't be, because I'm a grown-up, and I'm getting wet.
So you are.
Maybe it's the kind of beautiful day when boys get all wet and girls stay dry. What do you think, Timmy?
Possibly, but I'm a girl, and I'm getting all wet.
You're right. Another theory shot.
You know, I think it's the kind of day when rain is falling out of the sky.
What?
I think she's right.
And when rain is falling out of the sky, people who are outdoors get all wet.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I just noticed something.
What's that, son?
We're all outdoors, and Mommy is indoors.
By George, the boy is right.
Do you suppose
it's worth a try?
Yes!
Hooray!
It worked!
We tried! Yay!
Wonderful!
There. Now all my plants are watered. Gee, I hope the twiddle bugs didn't get wet.
Well, I see. This is the day to meet the letter Q. And here is something beginning with the letter Q. It's a quarter. That's right, 25 cents.
Yeah, well, I reckon I'd better be moseying along now.
Adios, Marshal Grover.
Thanks for the glass of milk, partners.
All right.
Okay, one horse, Fred, get ready. Here I come. Hi-yo, Fred! Fred, you are not supposed to move away from me like that. No, I'm supposed to jump on your back and you're supposed to stand just still. Okay, will you try it again, please? This is embarrassing. The guys are looking. Hi, guys. Okay, do not move away from me. Stand still, okay? He slipped.
Moved away from.
Slipped. Okay! Hi-yo, Freddy! You did it again. You moved away from me, Fred. It is not funny, Fred. After all, I am a marshal, and I am supposed to jump on your back. Now let us try it one more time.
Yeah, but it hurts my back when you jump on me like that, Marshal.
Oh, it hurts your back. Your little backy poo, it hurts. Oh, I'm so sorry, Freddy. I will not do that again. I know. I will never jump on your back again. Oh. Never anymore will I jump on your back.
Good.
Roll over. I will jump on your tummy.
Oh, it's times like these. I wish I was a cow.
The noble ostrich. The noble ostrich. The largest bird in the world. The ostrich is found in the sandy wastes of northern Africa. Sitting on shallow pits in the sand, This large bird lays the largest eggs in the animal kingdom. The mothers take turns sitting during the day. As the sun sets, the night shift begins. And it's time for the fathers to take their turns sitting on the eggs. The fathers do their share of babysitting and keep the young chicks from getting into mischief. The ostrich eats lots of grapes and flowering shrubs, but they prefer mice, lizards, and insects. The ostrich resembles other big birds. Unlike Big Bird, however, the ostrich has no vocal cords and can only hiss. The ostrich has only two toes, but can run faster than the horse. Capable of meeting the fiercest enemies, the ostrich can kick with his powerful legs. But in general, the noble ostrich prefers to run from danger. The end.
Touch, hold, feel, get to know about, reach, find, reel, throw away the doubt, close to so much wonderful. See it there, inside, don't hide it. Touch, hold, feel, nice things go with you. Reach, find, real, don't you know it's true? Be afraid, your heart is closed, and your hands in your pocket or your glove. So reach, touch, feel, find, love.
Oh, heaven! Look at this Snuffleupagus trash! It's big, it's beautiful, and now it's mine!
Oscar?
What?
What about trash and tail? Do you want me to explain my trash to the Grouchketeers?
Do I? Oh, tell us all about it.
All right. That empty can there was full of cabbage and spaghetti. My daddy bought it at the Snuffle Market. Oh, it's my favorite food.
Well, that must cost a lot, something that big.
Oh, no, that's just a small 50-cent size.
Whoa.
And next to it there is an old empty bottle of my mommy's perfume.
Ah, how about that?
And she puts a dab on her snuffle when she's going to the opera. And down below are some old ornaments for our Christmas tree.
Oh, they're huge. Say, Snuffy, remember me when you throw out that tree? Giant pine needles, what a mess.
And over there, those are my old jogging shoes.
Hey, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 shoes! You hear that, Grouchketeers? Snuffleupaguses have twice as many feet, so they have twice as many old shoes. Oh.
And that's my trash.
Boo! Boo! You hear that? We're all booing. Oh. That means your trash is a hit.
Oh, well, there would have been more, but the trash man came and took away the rest of it.
Did he say the trash man takes it away?
Yep.
Wow. That means he must take it somewhere. And where would he take it, Grouchketeers? Yes! There must be a Snuffleupagus dump, right?
Oh,
full of giant trash?
Yeah, Oscar, you are so brilliant, and you're right. There is a place like that.
Do you know where it is?
Yep.
Wow. Grouchketeers, Trash and Tell is over. Instead, we're taking a trip to the Snuffleupagus Dump.
Yay! Yay!
Okay, Mount Rushmore, take us to your trash heap.
All right, gang, follow me.
Boy, am I glad I made him a Grouchketeer. Hey, wait up for me!
Ring the bell and win a prize. Tit, how about you, young man? You look nice and strong.
Me? Oh, thank you.
Yep, like to play a little game?
Oh, sure, what this game?
Well, it tests your strength. You take that hammer there, you see?
Yeah, that there.
You hit it right here.
Yeah.
And it knocks the little weight up. And if the little weight goes all the way up to the top and rings the bell, then you win a prize.
All the way up there?
Right.
Oh, boy, me like to win prize.
Little does he know that I fixed this thing so nobody can ring the bell. Nobody's strong enough.
Hey, what you laughing at?
Huh? Oh, never mind. Go ahead. I bet you ring the bell the first try.
Oh, you think so? Okay. Okay, let me try. Here we go. Take hammer. Okay. Up there. Here we go. Bah! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
4, 3, 2, 1. Nope.
Oh.
Sorry, kid. You didn't ring the bell and you don't win a prize.
This harder than me thought. Me try again. Me hit as hard as can.
He'll never do it.
Are you laughing again?
What? Never mind. What's go ahead.
Okay, okay. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Too bad, kid. You didn't ring the bell, so you don't win a prize.
Me give up. Me guess me just not strong enough, huh?
Yep, that's it.
Oh, by the way, what was prize?
Oh, a cookie.
Cookie? Why you not say so? Me do anything for a cookie. Cowabunga! Oh, me do it, me ring bell. Give me cookie now. Oh, cookie.
Maybe I shouldn't have told him about the cookie.
Oh.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
I just wanted to tell you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. No! Don't touch these!
Okay.
So, where is this Snuffleupagus trash heap?
Oh, I don't see it anywhere. I was certain it was here someplace. Oh, dear. Oscar, we have been walking for hours, and it's raining.
I'm tired.
Let's go home.
Yeah.
Aw, hey, Grouchketeers. You're not gonna give up, are you? Why, a grouch looking for a trash heap never gives up. Why, you know what could happen? The next trash heap you find might be the big one.
The big one?
Yeah. The place that grouches look for all their lives. The dump at the end of the rainbow.
Look!
Oh, man!
It's the Snuffleupagus dump! It was right behind us all the time!
See, I told you not to give up! And so you don't forget to always keep looking, here's a song that all grouches live by. There's a big heap of trash at the end of the rainbow. There's a big pile of junk in that place far away. So search all your life for the end of the rainbow, and the big heap of trash may be your trash someday. There'll be bent wire hangers and kettles and cans, broken umbrellas and bottles and pans, washers and dryers and sofas and chairs, and all of them badly in need of repairs. There's a mountain of junk at the end of the rainbow, and it's rusty and dusty and dirty and deep. So look very hard for the end of the rainbow, and some rainy day you'll be king of the heap. There'll be bundles of papers and tires you can't patch, a million old sneakers and none of them match, and cars without wheels and wheels without cars, and a beautiful mess reaching up to the stars. So follow your nose to the end of the rainbow. Never give up, though hard it may seem. Walk on through the mud. Walk on through the steam. Swim every mountain and climb every stream till you come to the trash at the end of the rainbow. Trash heap!
It's a rainbow!
You big palooka! This isn't just your everyday giant trash heap! It's the trash at the end of the rainbow!
Walk on through the mud. Walk on through the steam. Swim every mountain and climb every stream till you come.
beautiful dream.
You know, Shaggy Face, this could be the start of a beautiful friendship.
And now, folks, they're lining up for the big race of the day. Over there we have number one, then numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. They're on their marks. They're set. They're off! A very fast start. Number three has jumped into the lead, followed closely by 2 and 1. As they round the first turn, 4 is going ahead of 3. Uh-oh, here comes 5 making his bid and forging into the lead. And rounding the final turn and coming toward the finish line, it's going to be a photo finish. The judge is now taking the winning number. He's walking down the line of weary contestants, ready to award the winner's wreath to the one carrying the matching number. And the winner, number 9.
At 6 o'clock, I roll my truck out into the street. Morning sun is shining on the trash that I will meet. There's broken dolls and rubber wheels, TV sets and orange peels, baby rattles, paper plates, newspapers and rusty skates. Ooh, keep on trucking. Got to sort it, shred it, burn it to ash. There's a lot of hard work when you're working with trash. Take it to the terminal, dump it on a barge, put it someplace that's awfully large. Ship it to a landfill where it decays. Cover it with dirt and make a park. Someday, you got to compact it, compress it, recycle, make less of it. You got to compact it, compress it, recycle, make less of it. Ooh, keep on trucking. Ooh, that's the garbage man's blues. We're running out of resources, running out of space. We don't have room for all that waste. We gotta compact it, compress it, recycle, and make less of it. There's a million things that garbage can do. Recycling saves energy too. Ooh, keep on trucking. Ooh, that's the garbage man's blues. Ooh, keep on trucking.
Hi all, Kermit the Frog here to talk to you about subtraction. Now, if you don't know what subtraction is sort of like, when you take something away from something, then how much do you have left? You know what I mean? Well, I'll show you what I mean. You see, right here, I have 5 numbers sitting all around me here. I've got a 1 there, I've got a 2 down here, got a 3 back there, a 4, and a 5. You see, that's 5 numbers. So if I wanted to talk about subtraction, then... Wait a minute. Hey, number 5. Hey, number 5, where are you going? Wow, that's not very nice. I was going to talk about subtraction and one of the numbers left. Well, I had 5 numbers, and one of those numbers left, and now I've got, I've got 4 numbers left. I've got a 1, I've got a 2, I've got a 3, and I've got a 4. Okay, I can... Now, that's not very nice. Here I was going to talk about subtraction, and the number just left. I had 4 numbers here, and one of those numbers left, and now I've only got 3 numbers. How can I talk about subtraction if things keep leaving? Well, I'll still talk about subtraction. Let's see, I still have a 1, I've got a 2, and I've got a 3, and... Ah! Is that nice? Okay, well, listen, my feelings aren't hurt. I still got 2 numbers here. I'll still talk about subtraction, because I've got 2 numbers. I had 3 numbers, and one of those numbers left, and then I only have 2 numbers. But I'll talk about those 2 numbers, and I'll talk about subtraction, okay? I've got a 1, and I've got a 2, all right? And thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, number 2. Okay. I had 2 numbers. One of those numbers went away, and I've got 1 number. And that number is the number 1. and I'm still going to talk about subtraction because... What's going on? Well, that does it. That does it. I had just one number left, and that number just sort of blasted off into the sky someplace. And now I got no numbers left. Huh? All I wanted to do was talk to you about subtraction, and I didn't get a chance at all. So did I get a chance to show you anything at all about subtraction? Huh? Did I? Well, I guess maybe I did.
Hey, kids, let's see you make a triangle. Very good. Now, everybody up, and let's see you make a square. Where's Benjamin? Hi, Benjamin. Come on now, Benji, you can do it. Very good. Now, that's a square. Congratulations, kids.
Sleep. At last. What's that? A fly. Whoa, what's that? A chicken. A drum playing rabbit. Ah!
You know there's a cookie lying on the table here?
Yeah, I know that, Bert.
Oh. Ernie?
Hmm?
Can I ask a question?
Oh, sure, go ahead.
Why is there a cookie lying on the table here?
Oh, you see, I put it there, Bert.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, to remind myself.
Oh, to remind yourself of what?
Oh, well, of circles, Bert.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you see, the cookie is round, just like a circle, you see?
Yeah.
And so every time I see the cookie, it reminds me of the circle.
Oh. Well, okay, but why do you want to be reminded of circles?
Well, you see, because circles remind me of squares.
They do, huh?
Sure. And I have to remember about squares because squares remind me of my checkerboard. See? Because the checkerboard is square, you see? And it's also made up of a whole lot of little bitty squares. See?
Uh-huh. I'm beginning to understand. This cookie here is on the table to remind you of circles, which remind you of squares, which remind you of that checkerboard.
Right.
And you want to play checkers.
Wrong.
Oh.
No, you see, I want to remember about the checkerboard because that reminds me of games.
Yeah.
And games remind me that I have to put on my football helmet.
I know I shouldn't ask this. Ernie?
Hmm?
Why do you want to put on your football helmet?
Oh, that's obvious, Bert.
You see, my football helmet reminds me of music.
Why is that, I ask foolishly?
Well, because there's always music played at football games. You know, bands playing and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I want to remember about music because that reminds me of bells.
Ah, sure. Of course it does. Yeah.
Right. And bells remind me that I've got to turn on my alarm clock.
Your alarm clock. Ernie. Hey, Ernie.
What?
Ernie, will you turn off your alarm clock, please?
Sure, Amber, sure.
Okay, now. Okay. Now, let me see if I got this straight, okay?
Sure.
Now, this cookie here on the table is to remind you of circles, which reminds you of squares, which remind you of checkerboards, which reminds you of a football helmet, which reminds you of music, which reminds you of your alarm clock ringing, right?
Exactly.
Ernie, why do you want your alarm clock to ring?
Well, because, you see, when my alarm clock rings, that reminds me that it's time to eat my cookie.
What do you do with a pet? You hug him, but don't slug him. You squeeze him, but don't tease him. You love him, but don't shove him. You give him water to drink, sometimes a bath in the sink. You give him food to eat, and sometimes a treat. You walk with him, and you talk with him. Run with him, have fun with him. But what do you always do with a pet? You pet him.
L. Lake. What a lovely looking lake. L.
Knock, knock. Who's there? It's a woodpecker.
Okay, listen up and listen good, Grouchketeers, because I only want to say this once. Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letters L and Q and by the number 12. Sesame Street is a production of...
The Children's Television Workshop!
Good. Now stick your thumb in your ear.